Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to change your voice like this with the plugin on OBS itself instead of a program. So this is just another type of thing you can do.
And we're going to change your voice with a VST plugin.
So basically OBS has a built-in way to run VST plugins. And under Windows, you need to have them as a DLL, which is a VST2. If you do VST3, the file extension is different, so it's not the same. You have to use VST2s. And it's better off if you can find 64-bit versions of the VSTs. Some work, some don't. So you might run into that where you can't get one to work. Anyway, this is what OBS checks for. It checks if there's any VST plugins in any of these directories. Now, instead of this percentage program files, it'll look like C program files. This is the 64-bit plugins, or here is the 32-bit plugins. I recommend that you use 64-bit plugins, so they're gonna go into the program files under VST plugins. OBS is not picky about if this is a capital or a lowercase in here. I have mine as a capital V, lowercase s, lowercase t, capital P, and it still works. So it's not picky about that. You can also get these in Mac versions, which are going to be .vsts. They go into Library Audio Plugins, VST, or Library Audio Plugins, VST Home Folder. Under Linux, they're going to be a .so or .o, and these are the paths that Linux has for the VSTs. Some places to get VSTs is Reaper and Milda Production. There's a lot of untested ones in here, but you can get a lot of free ones. These are different links, and I can provide this page in my description. Now we're going to be at pluginsforfree.com. And this is a vocal pitch shifter. This is what we're going to be using. We want the VST, that's a 64-bit version, so we want this file here. Okay, once you get that downloaded, and which I don't see a lot of YouTubers doing, is scanning the file before you open it for viruses. Don't trust every server to not have viruses. So once that comes up good, you can open this up. Like I said, we went to VST2, 64-bit version. See how it's a DLL? That's what file you need. Okay. Now, you're going to want to go to the drive that has OBS installed, which if you normally install it, don't change your directories. It's going to be under C, your local disk, program files, and then VST plugins. This is where you're going to want to install this file. I've already dragged and dropped it in there, so you see it right here. That's all you gotta do, is drag and drop it in here. If you do not have this folder, go back to your program files, right click on there, go to New, Folder, and make a VST Plugins folder. From there, you're gonna open it up, drop the file in, and you're good. Now that you have the VST installed, let's set it up in OBS. One of the better ways to do this would be to make another microphone that has the voice mod on it and your original one here. So first off, let's create another microphone, which is going to be the same one. Do not go in here and duplicate it, because if you do like a copy and then you paste it, it's going to make a reference. And if you reference it, when you change one, it changes both, so you don't want that. So we're going to add a new one. Audio input capture. Now I'm going to name this one C400 Patriot 990 Voice Mod. That's what I'm using for a mic, so I want to put that as my voice mod. And that's going to be my fast track, line 1 and 2. Now you'll notice that it doubles them up. You want to mute one of them. Otherwise you're going to have double audio. I'm going to put this at 2.5. That way it doesn't go over. Don't want it to peak and hurt people's ears. And if you had filters in yours, like I have filters in mine, these filters, this is what you're going to want to do. You want to right click, copy filters, go to your voice mod, paste filters. You got to go back in here. We want to do filters. And then you want to go here. It's a VST2 plugin. So we need to do that. I'm going to name it Voice Shifter. Then we need to find the plugin in the drop down list. If you don't have very many plugins, you'll see it right away. There it is, right there. I'm going to have mine open when active. That means if the microphone is in the scene, it's going to open the plugin. And what I mean by that, it's going to open this right up here. This is the plugin for the voice shifter. You can also right click on this, set a color. I'm going to do red. That way I can tell which one's what. Now the reason why I had you set up two microphones is because you can mute one and switch right to the other. It's a lot easier than going through your filters and disabling the plugin and then putting it back on, the VST. So what you're going to do now is go into File, go to Settings, of Hotkeys, almost all the way at the bottom, you're going to see your microphones. My voice mod went in the middle there. So what you're going to do is make a mute button and an unmute button. So I'm going to make control number 4 on the number pad to mute it, control number 5 to unmute it, number pad 5. Now, I've already done this before, so I have a mute on 1, number pad 1, and unmute number pad 2, number 2, for that. So now when I hit control number pad 1 for this microphone, it's going to mute it. Then all I got to do is hit control number 5 to unmute my voice mod. Just got to remember what you set these to. Once you set these up to what you want, you need to hit apply, then hit OK. Now you can switch back and forth to the microphones. Once that's all done, don't forget to go into here if you have a mono mic. Go to Advanced Audio Properties. So we want to find our voice mod mic. I'm using an XLR, so it's going to be a mono mic. So I'm going to change this here. If you click this, OBS will automatically make it stereo. That's what you're going to want to do if you have an XLR mic. You're going to want to click this to make it stereo. So, now that I've done that,
I'm going to show you how to change your voice. So I could be this little high-pitched person, and I can have my voice completely changed, or I can have my voice added with it
so it sounds something like this, and it's kind of disembodied type of thing. You can fine pitch all you want. You can go to a deep voice. A deep voice like this. Ha ha ha. Something like that. You know what I mean?
Anyway, if I change it back like this, it's back to my normal mic. So that's one way you can do a voice changer. So this is something you could do with OBS itself and not have to run an extra program like NCH or Confish, but this one doesn't have many options, but it's a simple way of doing it. Once you have this set up, you're pretty much done, so you don't have to change that after you set your hotkeys. You can change this all you want. So if you like this video, please like it. If you want to see more like it in the future, please subscribe, and I will bring you more in the near future. Thanks for watching.